Boys, what's up, everybody? I'm a little early on my intro here, but what's up, everybody? We're gonna have some fun tonight, fellas. I have been building the King of the Hammers qualifying loop. Hang on, my music's a little loud here. All right. What's up, everybody? I have been building my King of the Hammers qualifying loop over the past couple days, and I have added in one of the Pro Rock hills. I've added in one more really cool thing. I have actually added in Bikini Bottoms Off-Road Park to my map, so the entire park. It's been fun, and as always, I have new mods, new things to show you guys. I will say that if you're not following us right now, make sure you're following us on YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, wherever you're watching us. It really does help big time. So I do appreciate you guys joining us. We're going to have a lot of fun tonight, and it should be pretty cool. I'm excited to show you guys what we've been working on. First things first, let me get the map loaded up here. To do a little bit of housekeeping, I wanted to talk about the Pro Rock race real quick. People were getting real butthurt on the internet about lack of driver attendance, and honestly, like, I think it's kind of stupid to even worry about that at all. I thought the hills that they raced were really cool. Because they had lower attendance, they actually ended up running three hills rather than their normal two. So whatever floats the goat, but I thought it was really, really cool. If you guys see on screen, we are actually let's see here. So we are now keeping track of our followers on Twitch. So on Twitch, I know a lot of you guys follow me on Facebook and YouTube, and I've started going to Twitch because it's another way for me to monetize the stream. And the more money, the more incentive I have to do this, obviously, the more often I'm going to do it. So once we reach 50 followers on Twitch, we will be in the opportunity to do some cool things there too, to make some money, all that kind of fun stuff. So thank you guys for following us on Twitch. I've had people reach out, want to play the multiplayer with me. I'm planning on doing a viewer trail ride where everybody comes in, we all meet up on a multiplayer server, and we just kick ass and chew bubble gum. But first things first, we're gonna have a lot of fun today, and my map is sitting here loading. And we're gonna get this popping off. If you guys want to, let me know where you're from. Let me know how you're doing, what you've been up to, all that kind of fun stuff. Because guys, it's here. It's nighttime. We can all chill. We can hang out. We can just let it chill and vibe and all that other dumb shit that people say. Because the workday's over. It's only a few more days till the weekend. So we're almost there, fellas. And I'm super excited to have you guys here. Thanks for tuning in with us. And as soon as we get this going, I will show you guys some of the hard work that I've been up to. Because it's been a while since I've done like an actual stream where I've come in and I have like shown you guys what I've been working on, all that kind of fun stuff. So I'm excited to show you guys. Southern Ohio says, Rush was great as always. Joey puts on a hell of a show. Wish you could have been there, man. Yeah, me too. You know, it seemed like a much more intimate race, which I'm a big fan of. I know that, you know, when it's big hills like that, sometimes you're really far away. So I think that this time it really was like, felt really close. It looked big. It looked cool. I'm going to show you guys. I built the Leap of Faith that they actually ran last weekend. I built that in here, and I'll show you guys what it looks like when you run it. And as always, I do plan on releasing this map, but I am just doing more building. Like, I have even more things I want to do, and it's going to start tonight. Let me get this junk out of the way here. It's going to start tonight with me working on the qualifying loop that I'm building from King of the Hammers. So I'm super excited to show you guys. As always, I am using a steering wheel and gas pedal. So there's my steering wheel set up. I am in my work office. So if you're ever curious, I'm moving things around constantly, and I haven't decided how I want to set the stream stuff up, but we'll get there. You know, if the stream stuff takes off, I'll put a little bit more effort into exactly how it all goes, and got my nice mic handler now, so it should be a bit more clear. But let's get into the game. Let's pop off. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna first delete this car, old trusty, and I'm gonna show you guys some of the stuff that I've been doing since last time. So one is, I told you guys last time that I wanted to pull out all of the roads in the map and make them trails. So I've been started doing that. Obviously just throwing in some random trails here to kind of sauce things up, make it feel a little different. Obviously this is a very substantial change through here. I'm gonna have to flatten this whole section back out because I haven't decided what I wanna do here, but I built a guardrail trail here with a nice like exit on it. This is definitely more for like your regular old trail trucks. It's got a nice hard line out, all that kind of fun stuff. But like I said, I just kind of wanted to throw in some areas where you can go ride some trails and then go from one trail to the other system pretty easy. What's up, Isaac? It's good to see you, buddy. I'm happy you guys are here. And like I said, if you guys want, follow me on Twitch, guys. That really is helping me out here recently. But let me show you guys what I've probably spent the most time on here recently, and that is Bikini Bottoms Off-Road Park. Now, first and foremost, I got Old Glory. Is this game a game in Jason Heinrich says, sorry, Handrike, is this a game in development or for sale later? No, this game is live now. What I'm talking about being in development is the map that I'm building. This game is BeamNG Drive, so you can actually go and get that right now. And there's a bunch of different maps and different kinds of auto stuff that people do, but just hang out in the stream. You'll get a feel for what we're doing here. So what we have here is a scale replica. Jason, thanks, man. I appreciate you liking the stream too. We kind of have a scale version of Bikini Bottoms. We have the jump over the pillars, the big dirt circle that they run. I built Fable Hill out too, and I know that it's got a hard line here, but it's tough. It's tough, and I was actually going to clean the edges up a little bit. This is a super tough climb because there's actually a lot of slick stuff underneath here. Obviously, we have the wall. Now, I had someone ask me, where is the, you know, like concrete, like rebar things. I didn't even want to put those in. But out the top of this wall is concrete barriers. And obviously, we have a super steep climb out to the zipline tower. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to get Dustin in here, unmute myself. Dustin, how are you, buddy?
I am great. How's it going?
Good, man. I'm going to turn you down just a little bit. All right, talk for me.
Yep.
Better. Okay, cool. So I was just showing them Bikini Bottoms, and then I'm going to show you guys the Leap of Faith real quick. So same style where I just kind of cut out some of the other stuff. I built like this little climb here. It's kind of underdeveloped, but you know, it's nice. This is going to be the downway, but this is actually the Leap of Faith itself. And it's a pretty gnarly jump here. You've really got to hit it with everything you brought. So I'm excited about that. I'll show you guys some of that stuff. And it's funny, actually, the last time I think I was streaming, I was building the other rock bouncer section. It's kind of very Dirty Turtle-esque. So I'm going to fly over there and show you guys that too, because that's been completely finished as well. So I did a lane style thing. Obviously you've got like a super uphill right here, all this kind of fun stuff, and then a very Dirty Turtle reminiscent climb there with like rocks jutting out, all that kind of fun stuff, and got me a super slick mud climb right up the middle. I've got a climb right into a really steep rock wall up here. It's definitely not easy. And then also I have two really, really steep bounty hills that are super steep right there. And then there's the ultimate steep one, which doesn't, you know, doesn't really have the depth to it that it might, but hopefully that can show you guys just kind of how steep it is. So we're going to run some of these trails, and sooner rather than later, I'm going to be running these trails with you guys on a multiplayer server. So I have a service that will host my stuff for me for a really reasonable price. So I'm excited about that. And I don't think I showed you guys this either. I built a kind of the power lines, like the under the bridge trail. It's a lot of fun. But I'll show you guys the King of the Hammer stuff. Now, Dustin, I actually did work on this a little bit today too. So obviously this is a very rudimentary version of what it's going to end up looking like, but it's not too bad. Got the big tabletop that it goes into, got the first turn there, got to smooth out whatever's going on right there, goes into the second turn, and then I wanted the long straightaway, and this is where the course is going to differ just a little bit, because off the third turn, if I remember correctly, you go straight into like the behind the mountain section. And so I've got to actually change this, because when I was building this the first time, I hadn't thought about it. And this is going to be my rock section. So, you know, the rock mountain they climb and they go around. So I'm excited about it. And obviously lots of work left to do, no doubt. But that's why we're here. I'm going to work on it a little bit. I'm going to race it a little bit. And I have found that the development for these maps is a lot easier whenever you like race it while you're building it. So that's what I'm planning on doing tonight, guys. And like I said, if you guys are here, if you have any questions, jump in the conversation. Dustin and I both are here to be a part of it. Chris McKnight, my man, join me on Twitch. My man, thank you, buddy. That really does help. And as you guys see, it automatically updated that follower goal. So thank you, guys. I really appreciate that. It's really cool to see you guys supporting the stream. Now, I'll tell you guys this too. This is in my plans. If we can actually get like a decent following on Twitch and migrate some people over and get some good interaction on the stream, I'm going to try and get some stuff to give away like via Twitch only. So we're going to see how that works out. But yeah, man, thank you, Chris. I really, really appreciate it, buddy. It, like I said, you guys don't know how much it means whenever you guys support everything and follow in different places. Like it really helps. So thank you, guys. So Dustin is having some game troubles and some file troubles. So he's actually reinstalling the game right now. Other than that, Dustin.
Good.
Yeah, yeah. How's the day been so far?
That's been good.
Good, man.
Been good.
Did you have class today?
I did.
Very nice.
Got most of my stuff already done for the week, and we're actually nice. Off Thursday and Friday because we have a career fair.
Oh, very exciting.
So, and I call it fall break.
Yeah, right. Isn't it like 3 days?
Yeah, 2 days.
Yeah, that's nice. I always loved the fall break.
Goodness.
I think ours always tied into Thanksgiving, though.
Yeah, we always get a couple days off around Thanksgiving, too.
That's nice.
Sweet. Fresh groceries
are our thing. Hang on here. I'm going to go to my songs here. As always, I'm a big fan of you guys. If you have music recommendations, let me know, because I have to listen to certain kinds of music, and I'm not going to do it. I haven't gotten any DMCA strikes yet, like for playing this music. Let me do that. So I haven't gotten any strikes yet, but curious. Not to say that I like really want to, or like I'm trying to push my luck or anything, but I definitely am just testing the water. I think it's because I'm so small on I gotta figure out how to loop this around this mountain, because obviously this is the edge of the map. I think we're gonna have to just come straight up right behind this. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to flatten out this area, and I'm going to run it like all the way to the edge of the map. So I got some new pre-runners today too, some new trophy trucks, Dustin. Yeah, there's a whole Jason says, sorry, what am I supposed to download to get in this game? Looks insane. So you'll need to download Steam. And what I'll do is I'll put a link in it, or a link in it, or a link how to get to it, how to get the game. Holy cow. I'll put it on Twitch chat, and then I'll also dump it on Facebook. Y'all give me a second here. Make sure all the sound doesn't come in here. All right, there we go. All right, so that should show up everywhere. Awesome. And if you guys have questions, like I said, ask them, because I've got some really, really cool stuff in the works, guys. And I'm pretty excited about showing you guys everything we've been doing. But I did find out, like I said, that there's a huge community of like desert race guys, and they like have like actual racing leagues. So I'm going to sign up for one of their racing leagues, and I'm going to live stream the competition, show you guys how bad of a driver I am live in person. There we go. I was like, my music's not playing. Chris says, where's the Discord link? Let me get that link out. Mm-hmm. Now, what Discord is if you're not familiar, how do I even invite people? Oh, invite. I invite people.
Oh, that button right there.
Okay. All right, so I'll put this. I have been waiting for a map like this, Isaac says. Dude, I can't wait for you to play it. It's gonna be great, dude. And I'm gonna dump that right there. Now I'm gonna set up my Twitch where I can like, you can just basically, Twitch is really cool because you can do things like exclamation Discord, and it will just post you the link. So I gotta set all that stuff up though. I just haven't done it yet. Now I'm gonna kind of do a cheater version here of like a pass through, because you're actually like in the real qualifying loop, you come around this like mountain. Then you come up it, but we're just gonna chop the back half of the mountain off and bring you around. So it may look a little goofy, but it'll work. Now, I had someone tell me yesterday, I was like, hey, I'm gonna build the King of the Hammers qualifying loop. And they're like, they kind of scoffed and were like, good luck, sounds hard. Dude, do not ever let people tell you what to do, how you can do it. Do not ever let people discourage you, because most everyone can kiss your ass. And I have been extremely motivated here lately to like tell everyone that follows the stream, to tell everybody that's a part of the podcast, like all of you, like y'all can do whatever you want, and nobody can tell you what is good, what is bad. And it's just guys, it's really been like weighing on me heavy here recently, because I just can't stand when, like, I saw something the other day, and it was like the two things that'll destroy, and it was talking about like politics and stuff like that, but it was talking, it's a good life takeaway too, gaslighting and gatekeeping. Now what I mean by gatekeeping, if you're not familiar with that, is keeping certain information or tools or something like that behind some arbitrary gate, right? Like, you know, you're not cool enough to be a part of the club, or this or that, or, you know, that mindset, or you're not trustworthy enough, or this and that. And then gaslighting is, you know, when a group of people convince you of something that's not true, you know, in order to manipulate you or stifle you or something like that. And dude, it has been so heavy on my heart that like, God, people just should not do that. Why are people so bad? Like, I don't know, man. And like, everybody wants you to fit inside this little box, and you don't have to. You can literally do whatever you want. I'm literally, I spend 10 hours a day writing code, and then I'll come hang out with you guys for 2 hours playing video games. Like, you know, I had someone tell me, like, once you get married, your life is over. And then I was like, that has not been my experience. And now it's once you have children, your life is over. I'm like, that's not been my experience either. If you want to do something, you do it. And that's, and really that comes down to having like a really incredible wife that like, you know, is cool with me doing what I like to do and encourages that. But like, I support her in those things too. But the, like, guys, I'm kind of rambling a little bit, but all I can really say is do not ever let someone steal your joy, take from you anything that they cannot, like preserve the good things about you, because this world is so full of people that are sucky and want to make you feel bad because they feel bad. And man, I've just been on one, guys. It's been bothering me. I've seen too much negativity, too much division, too much gatekeeping, too much gaslighting. So I am confident you guys can do anything. Just been on it, guys. I started a podcast because I wanted to talk to people who raced, and it's turned into something that has blessed my family and blessed my ability to do, you know, all these different things that I love to do. And I just did it and didn't ask for permission. And you do it one day, and then that's just what you do. Like, all of a sudden, you know, like you're doing it, and you don't know what you're doing, but you're doing it, and it feels great. All right, my rant's over.
Yeah, well said.
That's, I tell people, you know, I have people ask me all the time, like, hey man, like, what did you do to get this started? Like, did you know, like, you obviously have a background in all this stuff because you're in tech and all this. Bro, I got no idea about anything. I hardly know how to do any, like, really anything. And, you know, I'm just like, well, you just decide that you want to do this and you do it. And you just make it work. You just figure it out. It's really hard to see the, like, terrain lines. Oh, I know what I need to do. What's up, dude? Hey, look, everybody. Special yeah. Guest. Come here. What's up? What do you need?
I want to be in.
Okay, what do you need?
I want a snack.
What do you want? There you are. What do you want? Do you need to stand over there so you can take? tell me what you want, we can get it. Okay. Hey, we do me a favor? Will you bring me my coffee, please? It's the best thing. Kids about kids. Little delivery service.
This is rude.
Yeah, I know. My coffee that's on the counter. It's in the coffee machine. So I have found too that adding roads in, like, where you may not typically, like, on the sand, you pretty much have to have a road, like, laid out, or else it looks goofy. Also, I want to say this too. I am 26 with two kids, man, and that's all by choice, by the way. No life forced nothing on me, and dude, I couldn't be happier.
Black.
Thanks. Yeah. Thank you. Y'all can just do whatever you want, man. Like, just do what you want. I couldn't be happier, man. A lot of people, they like I said, they have kids and family and think life is over, and that's such a sad way to be.
For sure.
Anyways, what you been working on? Or what you working on now?
Apparently working on a new logo for my RC stuff.
I saw that. That looked good.
I'm going to make an Instagram. And
get them big followers.
Oh, well, trying to, man. I don't know.
You can make it work. It's just one of the better things that I do, and like, I have no problems or qualms telling people this, to promote my podcast. I just find content that, like, makes me laugh and makes me want to, like, you know, be on social media, and I repost that kind of stuff all the time, like all the hill climbing videos and that kind of thing. I love reposting that stuff because, you know, obviously I'm gonna post my own content, but the other stuff keeps people interacting with the page. So I'm always a big believer in, like, reposting things, you know, sharing the wealth, like growing the network, and also the algorithms, they feed really heavily into that.
Absolutely.
But I will say that managing social media is a full-time job. It sucks. It's like easily the hardest part of the podcast, or was the hardest part of the podcast. Doing the actual podcast was easy. And for those who are listening, regulars, like, I don't do the podcast very much anymore. I have one guy who I'm trying to set an episode up with now, who's my shock tuner guy, and I just haven't reached out to him because I've just been super lazy. But social media's, it's hard. It's what my wife does for a living now. She likes a professional social media manager.
Gotcha.
So Isaac asks, what am I going to call this map? I don't know. What's a good name? I might take the best name from the streams.
Ooh.
Yeah. So y'all just let me know. I think it'd be pretty cool if you guys named it, actually. That's not what I wanted to do there.
Yeah, I'm really particular with stuff, and trying to get this logo, I probably worked on it for like 3 hours today, and it's driving me nuts.
Yeah, I feel you. I always outsource my logos because it's way cheaper for me to pay some guy to do it than me waste my time on it. And I always used Fiverr. Not sure if you're like familiar with them.
I know what it is.
Yeah, dude, it's the way to go. I'll never do my own logos. Like the loading screen that you guys see right here, this loading screen, cost me a total of $18 to make. So I thought it was a really good deal.
It's not bad at all.
Nah. And I own, it's actual artwork that I own now. So no one can, you know, say I stole their glass or, you know, whatever icon or font or anything. They can never come back and get me for it because I actually own all the art with it too. It was cool to work with an actual artist on it too. I'd never worked with a legitimate, like, graphic designer on something before.
Right.
But you do good logos. Like, you're actually good at it. I was never good at it. All right, we're gonna keep the roughness in there and kind of make this like a whoop section because the backside of the mountain's pretty rough. And I am going to take the grass and all this stuff that you see here. I'm going to take all that stuff down shortly. Just trying to build my track first and then worry about the rest of this stuff. But I will tell you this, the final touches, the details, make the difference. Hands down. Like the trees and the water and all that stuff. And I've really contemplated taking this like water feature out of the map right here. Like, cause obviously it's right next to a desert section. Doesn't make a whole bunch of sense, but it also still looks cool. Now I gotta figure out what's going on with this map, because there we go. Okay, I knew somewhere it was having some kind of issue. So if you ever see your roads disappear, you see how it's all like bound up in a circle right there and it's like overlapping? Try to fix that, because, or split the roads or something, because you can end up in a situation where the map just won't render because it's not square. Like, as soon as I fix that, it was fine. Like, right there is a really good example where I have some overlap on the map and it actually just won't render that section. So I'll scoot it out just a little bit and there we go. Okay, looking good. Feeling good about it. But Isaac is the one who asked me what I should name the map. If you were me, what would you name this map? Dustin.
Oh man, I don't even know. There's so many, like, I don't even know if you could like relate all the maps together.
Yeah, and that's, you know, as I was building this, I kind of felt like I kind of goofed a little bit by not having like more dedicated, like a more dedicated theme throughout the entire thing. But I'm kind of happy. I'm glad that I didn't do that. I think it feels, it's I kind of like it. Because I'll pretty much only have to load one map now.
Right. There's a whole world out there, so stop the waiting. Get your
parts and get going. Isaac says, have you used the TrackFab Ultimate mod? Dude, I have actually customized the TrackFab Ultimate mod, which I will not release because it's not my work. But I've customized it. I love it so much. I built it some high clearance links and things like that. It is definitely one of the most capable vehicles in the entire game, for sure. Okay, all right, so I think I'm ready to make this all. Do you guys hear this commercial? It's very strange. Okay, I've got it turned down. It's a commercial for like a clothing company. It's only made by blind people, which, cool, I'm good with it, I'm on. But it's a weird flex type thing. Like, does it look good? Is that what we are going for? Is that not what we're going for? Like, you would... Not sure if I, per se, would market it that way. But, again, I'm not, it's not my business, so... You do you. Man, there's, like, no in-between on this texture stuff. Like, I try to put in this rocky dirt right here. I guess it looks better, like, up close, but it looks pretty rough. Like, from high up. That's probably fine. Joe Thompson, what's up, dude? The creator of the UFO car. Thanks, buddy. I'm building the King of the Hammers qualifying loop right now. This is the giant mountain hill, I guess is what it'd be called. We're just working on trying to smooth it out here and build some of the terrains out so it's not so ugly. It's really cool to have like guys like Joe in here. It's really, really cool, actually. I'm gonna have to like start inviting these guys, like figure out a way if I can support them to get a machine to play this game or something. It'd be really cool to have these guys like come play on these vehicles that they, you know, they built.
Yeah, that would be crazy.
Isaac, I'm not sure what I would name it either. Not 100% sure. Kind of, I think I might let you guys. Right now, it's called Off-Road Paradise. That's what like the game file is called, but I'm not certain that that's what it's gonna stay.
Folders are the exact same spot.
You have no levels folder?
Like it did. Like it's the same way that it was whenever I showed you.
Okay, go in the game, launch it, and load like the Utah map.
It doesn't even load them.
It won't load like the default maps. No. Don't worry about the mods.
Oh, you're talking about that.
Like the stock Utah map. I think I've kind of just decided, Dustin, that I think I'll be okay without the other guys.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of one of those things where I'm just like, all right, y'all are welding. What do you think? How's that for the loop?
My Switch is a little bit behind.
Okay.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, no, that's good. You're gonna put the big rock at the Class 10 card nail in qualifying?
Oh, of course. You talking about the one that's like literally right here at the bottom? Yeah. Yeah, wouldn't be the hammers. And I'm gonna put another arch up here.
I bet my Twitch stream's like 10-15 seconds behind.
Try if your stream gets that far behind, try refreshing. I know that's kinda scuffed, you have to do it, but it may help. Alright, the question is when you come, so it loops you back in. So I need to raise this one up just a little bit. And guys, I'm actually going to do a hot lap test here in a second. So if you're waiting to see the map actually run, just give me just a few more minutes and we are going to pop off. Let me tell you, I'm going to go as fast as I can. I'm going to wreck, and then I'm going to decide to go way slower. It's going to be great.
what are you going to drive?
Oh, dude, it's called the Orange Dragon, I guess now. It's my knockoff Lauren Healy car.
Orange Dragon.
It's the one you saw last night, I think. Last night? I don't remember the last time we were on here. All right. So you're going to come. I guess you should really come straight off the mountain when you do this. I'm going to split the road right here. And then I'm gonna. Oh, nice, I got a street sign right in the middle of my road. Okay, I'm gonna grab this one. We're gonna take the same curve here, but we're gonna come out at a different place. And we're going straight for the finish line. I'm pretty excited because I'm gonna add in like a. Gosh, guys, I'm so bad at multitasking. My wife is right. I'm going to add in some, like bystander stuff and all that kind of fun stuff too, so it'll look a little better. It'll look pretty legit, I think. Like all the pits and buildings and stuff like that too. So I think it'd be pretty all right. Do you listen to Joe Rogan, Dustin?
I have. I used to listen to quite a few of them. I haven't much lately, though.
Yeah, he released one today with Bill Burr, and I'm pretty excited about listening to it. I'm going to listen to it tomorrow. All right, we're going to pop off and run this whole course. Also, if you can't tell, we are going, when we do release this and I do get it up on the multiplayer server, we're going to be having... contest to see who can run it the fastest, and the fastest will get like I'll post a picture of you or something on my Facebook with we crossed almost 11,000 followers the other day. Exciting times.
Yeah.
Now, as we open this conversation, I will say this as I do every time. This is not a vehicle that I made, but I would highly recommend that you go find it. All you need to do is you need to go to the multiplayer servers and just dig around a little bit, and you'll find it. That's the best I can really say. I'm not really going to like advertise something that's not mine, but this is a really cool mod, and I know you guys are going to ask about it, so there's that. Chris McKnight, how in the world did you delete individual trees and objects on the map editor? Okay, so I'll show you real quick, Chris, before we get started. So the objects, okay, so this is your object selector. This is good for like single place rocks and buildings and bridges. So like this archway right here, you can just click on it under object select. But if you want to go over here to a tree, you know, if you look, you know, I can't click on this one tree right here. I need to go to forest tools, and then up here on the left it says select item, and you'll see the white box appears around the trees, and then you can click on it and you can move tree by tree, or you can use these big brushes and you can delete stuff that way. Let me know if that did not answer your question. Y'all, I'm really hyped. I've been wanting to do this all day. And if you were paying, if you're paying attention just a minute ago, I put like 500, 600 horsepower in this thing. So it's about to pop off. Ooh, hang on, I gotta turn my game up. Go up just a little more. Better. If y'all wanna hear it louder, if it's not loud enough, let me know too. Hang on, my mic's in the way. I got a new mic stand and it's like, it's kind of difficult to deal with. Chris, you're welcome, buddy. Anything for you. All right, let's try this again. I got my mic like right up in my grill here. All right.
So are you gonna crash on the first
line? Oh, for sure. I didn't even make the first tabletop. Now, once I put like, you know, lines and other stuff in here, this will feel like a little bit more complete, but it drives good. Like I said, I'm a pretty sucky driver, so if I can drive it, you can drive it. There definitely needs to be a berm right there because it's hard to tell where to go. In fact, I'm pretty sure that's not where I was supposed to go. Kyle Listel, thanks, buddy. Dude, it's so good to see you. UC Fab in the house. What up, dude? That's awesome, man. Thank you, man. I really appreciate that. All right, so I need a berm there, too. And we're going up the qualifying hill. Oh, I gotta have rocks in here. Forgot the gigantic rock face I need to build here. Need to flatten that out too. Oh man, you know, I was literally just thinking to myself, like, I didn't wreck that entire time. I was so proud. But it's behind. I forgot.
Pretty close. Pretty close now.
Well, it'll buff out. Isaac says, what program do you use for making the maps? I use the built-in editor. So all you have to do is press F11 on your map and it'll bring up the editor. Yeah, Kyle, dude, come hang out with me anytime. I will tell you everything I know about this game. We are building the King of the Hammers qualifying loop. So once I get all this, like, all the details in for this map, it'll feel a lot more like King of the Hammers. It'll look a lot more like it. You're seeing the bare bones beginning, so welcome to the show. Ethan Andre, thank you guys. And hey, as always, I don't say it very often, but if you guys will share the stream, your name will get on the stream, all that kind of fun stuff. It does help me a lot when you guys do that. All right, this big old rock here, we're gonna bring it over. We're gonna rotate it around here. Kyle Listel, did you go to Proline by the Fire, or was that Gene? I saw a post today and it looked pretty cool. And I think it was you, but I wanna make sure it was you before I start rambling about it.
Gene went.
Yeah, I know he did. Can't remember if I saw Kyle did it or not.
His moon buggy's pretty sweet.
Oh, dude, killer. Okay, that looks pretty legit, actually. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy that. So I just press Control V or Control C, Control V for making this. Just Gene, sorry, man. I hope one of these days I'll make it out there to an event and hopefully we can hang out. It'd be really cool to see you, man. Congratulations on the land. It looks beautiful. I'm jealous. Every time you put pictures up, man, I'm like, I need to come out there and come hang out with you guys. Okay. Kyle Issel said, I was at the Nitro X Rallycross. Cool, dude. That sounds like a good time, too, for sure. Okay. All right, so time to add in some berms because there was some definite issues there in terms of where to drive. Okay, the most confusing one was this, like when you first get started. So I need to pull this up quite a bit. Yeah, for those who don't know, Kyle Listel is UC Fab, and he actually builds probably the highest quality scale vehicles in the United States. I mean, would you say that's fair, Dustin?
Absolutely.
I mean, the quality, the detail, the everything is just crazy, crazy unmatched, man. I'm always super high on his work. What are you saying? I'm sorry, I cut you off.
I'm just saying it's hands down the nicest stuff out there.
Yeah, the Jordan Pellegrino car that he's working on, I am jealous. That thing looks awesome. It always feels good when people like know what you're working on. So Kyle, I like really want to make sure you know. I know what you're working on because it's awesome what you do, man. Okay, so we're going to smooth this out. Kyle says, thanks, guys. Working on the JP98 as I watch will be done very soon. Bro, if you ever, like, I always try and, like, repost your stuff whenever you get a project complete, but send me some teaser pics, and I will funnel it all into that group you have or that page, whatever it is, man. I would love to help advertise that car or advertise the parts that you guys sell because... again, you guys make the best. Your work is the best. I just got to get you away from moon buggies and get you back into the... or I got to get you full-blown into the UTV life. I see it's creeping up on you. Cliff, thanks, man. Appreciate that. And like I said, if you guys are hanging out watching, share the stream. If you're on Facebook, just hit that share button. It's such a, I feel like kind of cringy saying that, but like it really does help, like big time helps. And what I'm doing now is I'm making these berms because when I was running through here just a second ago, I had no idea really where to go at this point. And also the berms really help you carry speed through these sections. So I want to make sure that I can still go pretty quick through here. Now the issue is when you hand build them like I am, you're always gonna have these like ruts and weird bumps and things, which is all part of it, you know, it's off-roading, right? But also try to make them smooth them out. Okay, now for this exit loop, and I'm about to rip it up again, guys, and take another hot lap. I almost made it the whole lap, Dustin, without wrecking, and I was like right on the verge of being like, dude, I made it, because I just really had like one more turn to go and I was home free, and then I drove straight into that rock. So hopefully this time that will be better.
Doing good.
All right, it feels good. Let me go put this arch up there. Now I'm gonna put a finish. I don't know. I only have a start and a finish, so I'm gonna just put the finish up here, and I might like transpose like a different sign on the front of it or something.
Yep. I put Bronco on it.
Yeah, I don't know if they have, like, there's a Bronco in the game, but I don't know if I could, like, there's a few of these guys that are really good at, like, making skins and stuff. I could always ask them to, like, reskin this thing. How's that? That looks nice.
Looks good.
Yeah. This one needs to be taller, for sure. And thank you guys for hanging out, man. I know it's late on a Tuesday. Is today Tuesday? I don't even know what day it is. Late on a Tuesday. We were out here having a good time, though. So, Dustin, do you watch any other live streams? Like, regularly? So, I stopped watching, like, the starting line and all that stuff, like, a long time ago. It's like, takes forever to get through that show. So, I stopped watching that one. I've never really been a fan of, like, Harley Designs, like, his show. His live stream shows, because it's just not like, it's just him like working on a truck. It's not super engaging. But
I watched a lot of his YouTube videos, but I don't ever watch the live stream.
Yeah, actually, I watch a ton of his YouTube stuff too. I think his like scale news update is really helpful. Really, really nice to see that stuff. As always, I got my preferred mug. And I had people, like Chris McKnight, which is a Southern Ohio off-road. He always, like, when we first started streaming this game, he would always tell me that I would, like, when I wrecked, it was because I didn't have my coffee. So I have my coffee and I'm driving better.
There it is.
So I gotta show you some of the stuff I got today. We're gonna swap out these tires for some BFG Bajas. If I'm trying to remember, like, maybe this didn't load earlier. I was having some, yeah, so there's a terrain issue on this tire, which I wish there wasn't, but it is what it is.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it's a cool tire when it loads right. But I've got a Bajas, which are perfectly fine with me. More appropriate.
That car really does look a lot like a
Honda. Oh, it's amazing. Okay, look at that. I mean, look at that. It doesn't get any better than that.
Think of Haley's teaser pics of the new one.
What are they doing? Why do they keep building new cars? Like,
so this one's specifically for K-Way.
I didn't even take a good look at it. Is it just all boat-sided? Like, what's the difference, I guess?
The independent front and rear.
Oh.
Rolls all the way around. Rear engine. You see.
Hmm. I did not look hard enough at all.
It's like a big razor. Like the trailing arm, IFSD, kind of like Pellegrino's car.
Interesting.
It's going to be pretty good.
That's actually really cool.
Talk about a high dollar car.
Oh, dude. I wish I did like that or anything like that, but golly, man, the budget is absolutely insane.
Running all of them. They're literally running an aluminum bulkhead now in Ultra 4 cars.
An aluminum bulkhead?
Know that?
That doesn't even make sense, I feel like.
They're solid axle, like the solid axle rear cars that they just had, it's a chunk. The center chunk is aluminum, the bulkhead.
Wow.
So that's what they're running in this car, and 74 Welds making portals for it. Beast.
Wow. That's interesting. I'm trying to figure out how to change. Oh yeah, that's what I wanted. God, that's an ugly orange. That's an ugly orange. I should just do something terrible like this, where it's like just orange on orange on orange.
You shouldn't do that.
Yeah, we'll see. I'm trying to think. If I had a race car, like the first one I owned was green, and I did not like it. But how does that look? That looks bad. That looks like a video game. brightness. Okay, let's keep it. Yeah, I just want it to be like a more rich. Yeah, it's not bad actually. Green looks like a cartoon. I may have to go with my classic purple, dude. Alright, I like it. Isaac asked me, did you buy your PC or build it? If you bought it, which one did you buy? I bought the Skytech gaming PC off of Amazon, and it's done just fine for me. It was expensive. I guess I know how to answer that question, because I know it's coming. And I
for
saved
gaming and PC.
Yeah, I saved up a long time for it. I'll say it like that. Ooh, send it. Let's go. Nailed it. Alright. I need to stiffen some things up quite a bit here.
If you didn't flatland it, you'd be alright.
I just need it to be a little stiffer in the springs.
Let's get Chris in here and he can do his magic real quick.
Dude, I wish. The thing about this game, though, is I don't think it operates. Like, the terminology, I don't think operates the same way. And I have found that the way that they, I don't know, for a lack of better terms, I think the rebound bypass is actually how much, the percentage of how much it can go up the shock before it works. So like this one, like the rear bypass, rebound bypass, it'll let it go 54% up the shock before it experiences strong bypass or strong resistance. So like bump bypass, it can go 50% up the shaft before it starts getting bumped, like dampened. And then same thing for rebound. It's a little complicated. Sometimes I just randomize it and go from there. Sometimes it works better.
So does this car got a locked diff?
It's welded in the back and locked up front. Front end's a little too stiff. She is hauling the mail, though.
Look at you.
I need to get a camera on my steering wheel.
Yeah.
Oh no. Chris says, have 34 hours and beam shock tuning alone and still have not 100% figured out the tuning. Yeah, me either, man. It sucks. I found a guide online. Oh, let's go. I found a guide online, and rear end needs to be stiffer. It kind of explained it the way I explained it just a second ago with like the percentage of the shafts and stuff. Hang on, we got a new follower. Craven Cookies. Same, dog. Thanks for the follow on Twitch, buddy. I really appreciate that. We're killing it tonight, guys.
That's pretty good.
I'm trying to haul the mail, Mr. Cookies. So I definitely need to change that right there. I definitely need to smooth all this stuff out because it's a mess. Accidentally hit my shift up. Driving like a madman. Cookies just put in chat and just says crash. No! I don't want to crash. I'm trying to. Yeah, I've got to come in here and clean up these edges. Oh my gosh. Alright. These edges are so bad. Now, the way you do that is you're just going to use our really smooth editor here. Drop it to 100% pressure. Come through here and smooth out this middle section here. Cookies gave me the crying. Sorry, dog. I'm built for speed, man.
It's
Yeah, this is so scuffed through here. I don't know why. Like, it's so bent out of shape. That was probably not what I should have done, but. It's funny. My music was just like talking about crashing a car. Joke's on me.
What's that coffee doing for you now?
Oh, dude. I'm amped. I'm ready. Just getting started. Craven says, what happens when the front axle snaps? Dude, the car just won't work. It just is what it is. So I'll show you guys here in a minute what it looks like whenever we crash at full speed. It's not pretty, I'll tell you that right now. Ew, gross ads. I just need to pay for Spotify Premium.
Not a bad idea.
Yeah, I pay for Apple though, and Apple's way better.
That's what I got. Fresh for everyone. Free pickup on orders of $35 or more. Restrictions may apply. So, when's the last time you riding an AOP?
Ooh. Kroger. May of this year. The moment you
fire up a Gator UTV. But yeah. But wait, that's the same time I went.
Yeah, I was up there really early this year. Maybe even like earlier than the year than that. I was there before you. I think it was April. Cookies just said ads, thumbs down. Dude, follow me on Twitch so that I can run ads and make money. That's funny. All right, let's try this one more time.
I see in some videos of the park, it's dug out.
Oh yeah, it's not fun for UTVs anymore. Adventure is like really rough. Let's go. Perfect landing. Big money. This is it. This is my run. No mistakes. Excellent focus.
I'm letting you commentate this because I'm like 5 seconds behind you.
Excellent focus. I gotta stay on the gas though. Incredible speed. Fourth gear. It says I'm doing 120, so officially the fastest Ultra 4 car. Bank is way better. That bank is way better. Still a little confusing on where to go. And I lost control. It's fine. Cookie says this thing's built like a truck. It's because it is a truck, dude. Alright. I just did the cleanest drift I think I've ever done.
That looks pretty. Oh man, look at you go.
I told you, man. Just had to get the coffee in me. Come around this here, and I think I've still boinked. Yeah, this turn is still crap. All right, now I've got the rock section. These rocks are really big. Too big. This is not the finish line. Oh, almost. Alright, so a couple more areas need some work.
Yeah, you're missing a few bars in front of you.
Yeah, it's a little smashed, but I wasn't gonna stay there long enough for anybody to look at it. Alright, smooth this out. Now, these are some big old rocks right here. Like real big. Yeah, I did, but I don't know if I could do it again. So I think I may have gotten really lucky there. Yeah, you really go around this curve super blind. Need to raise it just a little bit right here. That's probably fine. There's your big rock, by the way. You'll see it just like enormously sticking out. I'll put one down here too, just for funnies.
I see that video all the time on Facebook. It's just, oh man.
You know I'm never gonna be able to drive past this thing and not hit it if I put this in here.
It's alright.
Right. That's perfect. It's great content.
the rock for when you're having a really good pass.
Oh yeah, it's great. I'm gonna make it. I mean, actually, I'm gonna use a different rock. The pack rocks are really nice because they're like circular. Oh my god, it's so big.
Oh yeah. Just wait to mess up your day.
I literally just put it right in the middle of the trail. It's fine. cookies, man. Why are you trying to get me to crash so bad, dude? All right, Cookies over here, give me the thumbs up, crash, and the okay sign. Come on, man. All right, let's assess the damage. It'll buff out. Look, yeah, I mean, look. I don't think you need A pillars. I heard that on Facebook. That's a clean one right there. Ooh, let's go.
That was nice.
I told you, man, I'm getting better at this. Had somebody tell me the other day, too, that they're like, you're never going to be able to steering wheel these, like, courses we built. It's like, y'all kiss my ass, dude. Y'all don't believe in me, worth nothing. That's it, man. Wait till you see me drink a Bang. And then I'm like tweaked out. I'm really tweaking. Oh no, we've reached the part of my like playlist on Spotify where it's all like soft jazz music. I need some like AC/DC or something crazy right now. Nice drift. So I'm also going to show you guys what this looks like when you run it at night here in just a minute. I'm not sure if you messed with that, Dustin, but you can actually turn on your lights and make the sky dark too.
I messed with the lights. I messed with the
Bryce White, like the stream. Thanks, buddy. All right, big rocks. Nice. Okay, go slow. Nice. So far, this is the farthest I've made it without my car blowing up. So is this about to be the first lap I've ever finished? Oh, no, 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 no! What?
See? I said to say something.
Look.
You see the finish line?
No. I didn't even make it that far. Look, you see, what happened was there was an issue with the car, and it caused me to wreck. It's
You were so close. You were so close.
Obviously, whoever designed this car wants me to fail. Cookie says making car noises. Awesome. Thanks, man. All right.
Sure, you're giving him what he wants.
Yeah. Okay. I feel like it's good. I feel like I'm pretty pleased with how this turned out.
It flows really well.
It does. I think maybe back here there's like a few things I wanted to smooth out a little bit, but not much. Oh boy, oh boy. Like I said, if you guys are not following me on Twitch, follow me on Twitch so that I can make money. Alright, you know what has to be done, right? We gotta run this in the bomber. And I do not have a bomber tuned for this at all. I could run a trophy truck through it. Oh, you want to see something cool I got today? I think it's pretty cool. It's actually really cool. It almost crashed my machine earlier, but it's like really a really high-end mod. I also have to give my props to the guys who made this over at the I think it's CRD CRD Off-Road Racing. I did not make this mod. Don't talk to me about it. I don't know anything about it.
So you're to drive.
I'm just here to wreck my car because that's what I'm best at. And even then.
The rear-wheel drive? Because you're gonna struggle.
Oh no, it's four-wheel drive. Oh no, it is. No. It is rear-wheel drive. I suck. Yeah, we'll give it a shot. We'll see what happens. I'll probably be super frustrated and go back to the bomber. It's also got like no power. Definitely gonna clear this jump.
Yeah, buddy. So it looks good.
Oh, it looks great. It's first turn, I'm gonna be so pissed, I can feel it. I have not gotten out of first gear. Definitely not going to be my fastest loop here. I feel like in these two-wheel drive cars, you really have to like use the banks to turn rather than actually turn.
That's pretty good.
It is smooth though. It's got a twin beams up front. There we go. That's what I wanted to have happen.
Did you put the purple on there?
Nah, dog. That was purple by stock. People love purple. Purple equals win. Dang, dude, this suspension is like really tuned well. I can't climb the rocks. Okay, I just went around them. That works. Oh no. No good.
Do you mean to do that?
No, it's just two-wheel drive problems. All right, let me get in the bomber and show you guys how this is done. I could do it in the UFO too. I forgot about that. Arguably the best car in the game. Like, in my opinion, probably easily the best car in the game. Yeah, it would it dominate. All right, let's go. Hang on, I gotta put a thing in the engine because it's got no power.
Put a thing in the engine.
Bigger cam, performance block, whatever. No. Definitely could use some tuning on this one for sure. Drives well though. God, it's got so much power. It's because of the engine thingy. Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
That's still something I can't really let run.
This car is like super loud. I can't really hear you. Hang on one sec. I'm about like almost through this lap. If I finish this lap, first try with the bomber, I never go back. Solid axle wins every year. It's kind of messed up. Hang on, I gotta focus. Get distracted. Oh, That was not good. About there, boys. About to have our first completion. I feel it in my bones. This car is too stable, too fast. Finish line's in sight.
Oh no! Oh no, no! No!
Listen, that wasn't even on purpose. That was 100% an accident. God dang.
Oh, man.
All right.
Wasn't going to say anything until I seen you get to the finish line.
Damn it. I need to tune this thing. Even if it's only your world, every day, someone signs something that means everything. Visit DocuSign.com. DocuSign, as real as... These commercials are getting out of hand. I'm not sure if you guys can hear the DocuSign commercial that was just on here, but what in the world? Golly. Also, this bomber is like super loud. Something I think is like super dumb is the Missouri ad. Is the bomber doesn't have bypass on the front.
That is good.
All right, we'll try this. I would like to do a poll. If you think, hang on, here's what I want to do. I would like to do a poll. Let me see if I can set this up. Turn this dang car off because it's so loud. I don't know how to set this stuff up on Twitch. Let's see. Creator dashboard. Is that what I need to go to? Stream manager. No. Okay, anyways. Oh, manage stream. Edit stream info. Is there some, I don't know. Whatever. I don't care. Okay, whatever. It's annoying. If you think I'm going to make it, put a one in chat because I need some help. I need you to believe in me. More than anything, I need you guys to believe in me because if I don't make it, I might rage quit and just be done for the night.
No, it's not gonna happen.
Okay, alright. Alright.
If you don't make it, you need to get the UFO out.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. If I don't make it, I'll give the UFO a try. Alright, here we go. Alright, I got it. Here we go. I got people believing in me. God, you guys. I like it. You guys believe in me. Alright. Dustin, screw you. You don't believe in me.
I'll just be quiet now.
Okay, really short on the jump. That's all right. I still made it. I did not do... I changed the shocks completely and did no testing before I committed to this. Yeah, it's the car's fault always, man. It's that engine thingy.
Too much power. That's squirrely.
You don't even know squirrely. Definitely need a stiffer sway bar in the back. Yep. And go ahead and suck my butt. It was not on purpose, but it definitely was planned. Being very cautious, if you can't tell, I'm like very cautious right now. Alright, here comes the rocks. Oh no! That's alright.
Right.
Oh, come on. Come on. No, 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 no. And we're back. Completely legitimate. Frame is absolutely mint.
Oh my god. Spare tires, not just spare.
It's the donut, man. You know, I was thinking the same thing, but I was like, man, maybe I just tuned it completely wrong.
No, you have no shock.
Missed the big rock, thank you. I'm going across that finish line. Yeah, you're actually right. I think my front right, coilover is completely smashed in. I think both of them are smashed in, actually. There she blows. Hey, look. It's not perfect. It's not perfect. I never signed up to be perfect. That's all right. All right. Let's try the UFO.
I don't think you're ready for that yet.
I think it's easier than this one. Like, that's been my go-to car. Also, after this, I am going to go doing some rock bouncing. Michael M says, what mod? That car is sick. It is the Bomber mod. You'll have to do some searching to find it on the multiplayer forums, but it is out there. All right, fellas. This is obviously a Joe Thompson Ultra 4 car that has been tuned to the way I like it. It's got big power. This guy is ready. All right, good start. This thing handles so good. It's like third gear, just bogs. Oh, let's go.
Right.
Moment of truth. Easy. Ooh, maybe not. I see metal flying down the hill. I think it was just my light bar.
spare tire to somebody.
Oh, yeah. Never needed one of those anyways. Justin, thanks for liking the stream, man. If you guys are not already...
Oh, don't mess up right here.
All right. How's that for a finish?
Nice, very nice.
That's nice right there. Yeah, if you guys are not already, follow the stream on Twitch and YouTube, Racing on the Rocks, and Facebook as well. Thanks, guys. We have obviously a little bit of work to do on the map, a little bit of work to do on my driving, just a little, not much. Good, not great. But we're going to go do some rock bouncer stuff. I'm going to get out the rock bouncer and play around a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Take it back to the home roots. Okay, did you ever get your files fixed?
No.
Okay.
This thing's absolutely garbage.
Share your screen for me, and we can... I can go through it with you while I'm doing this over here. Sorry, thanks for being patient.
Good. I'm a little bit jealous.
Well, hopefully I can get you squared away with this thing.
Okay, so. Such a sick looking hill.
Yes, I can. Give me 1 second. I'm trying to keep an eye on like chat too while I'm doing this. There we go. That's what I needed. Okay. Let's see here. So this is what happens when you actually. Do you care if I share this on the screen so everybody can see what we're doing? Do you have anything like personal, you think?
No.
Okay. Like, no, you don't, or no, don't do it?
I don't have any personal.
Okay. All right, so he's having some issues with getting the mods to work. So everything looks good here. So you have a levels and a mods folder. So if you go into mods, what's inside there? Nothing. Beautiful. Okay. If you go back into the levels folder... Should have Utah. Perfect. Okay, so what you want to do is my files that you got, that you downloaded, in a separate file explorer, open that zip file. So on your toolbar, right click on file explorer and then just open a new one, like down there at the bottom. Yeah, there you go. Go to downloads. Okay, open that, click in it. Okay, Offroad Paradise - Main. That is your issue. Click in there. Okay, grab that folder and drop it in your levels. So when you got it off GitHub, it gave you the branch, which is Offroad Paradise - Main. And for those asking, this is private for right now. We will, once we get everything figured out, we will get it all public for everybody so everybody can play on it. But in the meantime, this should actually fix it for you.
Oh, I actually need to get all my mods back.
We can do that. I want to make sure that you can get to the map before we do anything else.
Let's do that.
This rock bouncer kind of sucks because it doesn't have enough power.
Oh. I see it's got a Mad Rim Love sticker on it, but apparently it's not good enough.
It needs more? I'm just kidding. I actually just put 1400 horsepower on here. I didn't know I could do that. Now, I am going to tune this out just a little bit. Bring my front coils down, rear coils down, front dampers. Keep those up. Bring these all the way down, front sway bar down. Cookie says I'll scroll through a scroll through a BMG Lives, but they suck. Oh, okay. I scroll through BeamNG Lives, and they suck, but yours is the money shot. Thanks, dog. Appreciate that. I like to have fun. And I do things a little different than everybody else, so I am more than happy to come hang out and all that kind of fun stuff. That's a big hill. And I gotta turn my game down. It's like just so loud. There we go. Actually, I think that's the same volume as my music.
I kind of peaked seeing you had a picture of a Hatermaker over there.
I do. I use that for one of my other stream things. I think it's gonna race again. Cookie says BeamNG is for crashing, but yours is just about rocks, dude. I just like playing the game, dude. A little bit of crashing, a little bit of rocks, whatever it may be that day. Okay, I hate this transmission that's in this car. You have drive, and then you have like sequential, and then you have your gears, and you don't have an option to change it. Yeah. Ooh, let's go. Almost.
You got some speed there.
Yeah, I put a 1400 horsepower in it. That's it right there. Bouncer style.
I know it's early in the week, but what's your prediction for this weekend for winning Bikini Bops?
I don't know, Tim. I don't know. I don't know, man.
Yeah, you really can't really bet against Timmy.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm losing my interest. Bikini Bottoms is such a hit or miss park because it's very punishing. If you make one mistake, it's extremely punishing. I don't know. I think the easy answer is to say Tim, but who knows? I think Cash typically does good. Oh, Danny does really good there, too. Yeah, I'd probably say Danny. Tim, Danny, and then Larry Krogh, if he's got his trans stuff figured out. If not, we'll put Jake Pike up there. Michael M says, any chance you know the author of the bomber? So that's kind of why I don't promote it. This, you know, whatever people feel certain ways about this stuff. I think the author is not the guy. The guy who published it may not have been the guy who made it. So I don't know 100%. I think the guy who published it, his name is Tom. So, yeah. But, you know, I would just do some searching before you go asking around for that guy. Kind of landed himself in a little bit of hot water this week with some of the guys I know.
So I got some good news for you.
Yeah, this thing needs some work to be like a killer. Actually, that wasn't too bad. I think I just don't know how to drive.
So I'm happy to report that I am loading into Off-Road Paradise.
My man, I told you we could get it figured out. Now all you gotta do is download the newest version.
Load up, we'll see. But at least it's clear. Alright. You'll wax your time with the AOH course.
I don't think that you have the... So I just finished that course. Thanks, Brandon, for liking the stream. I just finished it. I don't think you'll have it. You may have part of it.
I'm just saying that.
Oh, yeah. Good luck. I'm just kidding. My time was terrible. You do have these bouncer hills, though. Chris says, Cash had a smoking run going until he broke at the rollover. Yeah, I looked away when that was happening. Yeah. And I don't know what happened. Was he okay? I know people were kind of worried.
Yeah, he was all right. He was downhill right before the finish line. And they kind of like run across that ridge and then kind of tear down the hill. He came off it pretty hot. It was kind of two-wheeled. He barrel-rolled like two or three times.
Mm. He broke his leading arms, right?
It broke the sway bar and it broke the, it didn't break the leading arm. It broke the sway bar links in the front, and then his axle ones, the lower high steer arm, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
It pulls underneath the knuckle and bent it all up. And then,
mm.
Yeah. It broke a bolt and stuff for the
Hmm, that's expensive. I don't know if you're watching the stream, but this thing's doing work.
I'm watching the stream.
It's pretty, I'm impressed.
I'm taking this, in-stock truck. Just go hit the bouncer hills with it.
Yeah. Yeah, Chris, I actually need to get you this map, too. You can do some more testing for me, buddy. See you, Cookie. All right, guys. I think this actually might be it for me. I'm gonna go hit. I'm going to go hit Bikini Bottom, and then I'm gonna peace out. Gotta get some rest. My son was up like a million times last night, and I think my wife was pretty mad because I was like continuing to sleep, and she was getting up a lot. And if she knows I'm staying up late and then I like complain about needing more sleep, she won't be happy about that, I can tell you. Which is rightfully so. Alright, let's see if I can send it up. Good old Fable Hill. Ones?
The bouncer hills that, like, you were just on?
To the left of the mountain, like, keep going left. When you spawn, like, go left and you'll see it. Really? I wonder if you downloaded the, It's not any different?
So.
Hmm. Well.
Sure.
Huh. Okay. All right, guys. I'm going to call it a night. Like I said, make sure you guys follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, Twitch, all that stuff, and I'll let you know when we're going to be on again. After that, guys, I'm going to bed. Because I am super tired. So I will see you guys.